Hello. The original Doom and Doom 2 are among my favorite action games of all time. And luckily for me, it's also one of the most moddable games of all time. So I'm always looking for new, interesting ways to play. Sometimes tinkering around a little bit, trying to make my own game modes and maps and stuff. It's fun. And I've played Doom 1 and 2 so many times, and I'm so familiar with them that I'm particularly interested in new modes, like gameplay modes. And this is one that I found that is pretty interesting, and I thought I would show it off. This is running in GZ Doom. There's a link to the mod in the description. It's called the Keymaster mod, or Keymaster mode. I'm using the Ultimate Doom WAD to play. I'll probably go through at least the first three episodes, possibly the fourth, I'm not sure. I'm not a huge fan of the fourth episode, but it's fine. So start off here, knee deep in the dead, ultraviolence. Okay, so the premise of the Keymaster mode is that you cannot go to the exit until you find the master key, and the master key is held by a randomly chosen monster called the Keymaster. And you cannot kill the Keymaster until you find the Arrow of Slaying. And up at the top of the screen there, you see fading in and out is an arrow icon. So this is pointing me in the direction of the arrow, because you need that to kill the Keymaster. Down in the bottom right-hand corner, you can see you have all of the traditional keys. So you have full access to the level. You can go anywhere, but you cannot exit the level until you kill the Keymaster and get the Master Key. And the Keymaster is a much tougher, much faster version of that monster. So, and the location of the arrow is also random. You can play with an option set that where it's statically placed every time for like races and competitions and stuff. But I have it set to random. So, the first thing that we have to do is, you know, start playing Doom normally. You know, still Doom. It's not that big of a change, you know, gameplay-wise. But having to kill the Keymaster and get the key before you can leave definitely changes the way that you play in some interesting ways. Not having to worry about finding the traditional color keys, you know, makes it a lot less, you know, maze-like. You don't have to solve all the puzzles and everything. Although you do sometimes have to solve the puzzles just to get to wherever the arrow and the Keymaster are located. So that shotgun guy over there with the key icon floating over his head, that is the Keymaster. And he is invulnerable until you have the Arrow of Slaying. And it looks like the arrow is, it's either in the big central chamber that I avoided or... Actually, yeah, it looks like it is. So I went a suboptimal way by taking this secret path over here, and I have no way to get back in there. So I'm just going to have to run past the Keymaster for now and get back to that central area. Oh. And the Keymaster will chase you down. You know, the AI is the same as any Doom monster. If they are aware of you, they will try to get to where you are. So in the later levels where you have some tougher monsters that can potentially be the Keymaster, it can be a harrowing experience having like a Baron of Hell chasing you, you know, throughout the level until you can find the arrow. And it's pretty interesting. It makes for some interesting dynamics. Also, I was totally wrong. The arrow, okay, so the arrow must be in that secret chamber back there. Just run through and quickly pick up this armor that I missed. So already, you know, E1M1, you know, any Doom fan is going to be intimately familiar with this level, and you know, this has already drastically changed the way that we have to play. So I'm into it. And okay. Okay, so not only is the arrow in the secret area, it's in the secret area behind the secret area. And as someone who isn't super familiar with all of the secrets in Doom, hunting down the arrow can sometimes be a challenging experience because it can be anywhere on the level. I think it replaces... it can replace any of the... You know, any of the items, like a weapon pickup or an ammo pickup or health. I think it randomly replaces, you know, any one of those. And if you try to kill the Keymaster, you get this message here. Alright, so I need to lower this elevator, which you do by running over a secret line there behind me. And there it is. I probably could have seen it if I had... Well, I don't know, this panel might not have been open. Okay, so let's kill this guy. So he has 3 times as much health as a normal shotgun guy, which is why it took me 3 shotgun blasts to kill him instead of 1. And the other aspect of the Arrow of Slaying and the key is that each one doubles the amount of damage that your weapons do, which is not that big a deal because there was only this one imp left, but that'll come into play later. And sometimes I play very recklessly trying to find the arrow just to double my damage, which, you know, makes the game easier. It reduces the number of resources you consume by 50%. Hey, I think I 100%ed it. Nice. And it only took me 33 times the par length. Oh wait, no, that's not right. So that would be 5 times, it's like 12 times, okay. I can math. Okay, so new level, new arrow to find, new Keymaster to slay. And we don't have to worry about, you know, about playing the levels in the typical manner. You know, there's a part of my brain that tells me, you know, I have to go this way, I have to get the red key before I can circle around and go through the red door. But none of that applies here. I can go anywhere. And there is an option that you can set. Actually, there are a few options. I'll show those off here. So you can choose not to start with all normal keys. These are all the default options, by the way, except for the radar ping, which I turned off. So you can choose not to start with the normal keys to play it more like a traditional, you know, Doom map. But I like having them all, because, you know, having to hunt down the color keys on top of everything else, you know, not something that I really want to do. I mean, I've done it a million times. It's not like a challenge, but finding the keys and solving the puzzle. So you have level persistent picks, which that's the option I was talking about, where if this is on, then they will all be kind of statically placed. So I turn that off. The radar ping, technically I'm depriving myself of information by turning this off, so I really, you know, I'm limiting myself, but it's extremely annoying. And that's just a me thing. I hate repetitive noises in video games, like the Zelda health beep. That's just something that that I'm not into, so I turn that off. And you can disable the radar icon, which, if you really want to make it challenging, you know, make yourself, you know, have to methodically explore every level, you can turn this off. So the Keymaster has 6 times the amount of health as a normal Doom enemy, but because the arrow damage bonus is double the normal damage, that's actually, you know, functionally it's 3 times the amount of health. So your damage doubles once you pick up the arrow, and it doubles again once you pick up the Master Key. So getting both of them is equivalent to quad damage, which is quite nice. I'm using my music mod, which I don't know if I've talked about before. I was using it in my demonstration video for my mod, Hoofing It. This is a music mod featuring the music of a band called Bull of Heaven. They are I'm not sure if they are technically active or not. One of the two founding members tragically passed away a few years ago, and the band you know, when you have two band members, one of them passing away is kind of a big deal. But the remaining member, I think, has published some music under the Bull of Heaven name, but their output is not what it once was, of course. But they are an experimental art rock band, noise rock. They do a lot of, you know, drone music, a lot of ambient music, and I put together a little playlist of some of their best tracks to replace the standard doom music. I'll link to that in the description as well. And finally, I'm using the Smooth Doom mod, which, if you've noticed the animations being much smoother than they should, you know, with many more frames, that's why. So, quite a heavily modified experience. Also, I set a lot of options in GZ Doom that some people might disagree with, such as full 360 degree aiming, the crosshair. Hello. Got the arrow of slaying. Nice. I play games to have fun, not to punish myself or to stick to some arbitrary, you know, notion of purity or whatever. So I customize my experience as much as possible to make it as fun as possible. So if you don't like it, watch someone else. And, you know, I disagree that having full 360-degree mouse look actually makes the levels easier. I mean, or makes the game easier. Like, there are some levels where you have to shoot switches that are... Okay, so, say this panel, this wall panel here is a switch. Okay, say this wall panel was a switch. Okay, so, with Vanilla Doom, where you can only turn left and right... There might be some sort of elaborate puzzle where I have to flip a bunch of switches and make a staircase appear here. And then once I climb the staircase, I will be at the appropriate height to shoot this panel. And that could be a puzzle. That almost never happens in the classic Doom levels, Doom 1 and Doom 2. There might be some more of that in like Final Doom and stuff. I'm not really 100% sure. So it's almost never an issue anyway, but I think, like, Doom Guy would be able to aim at this panel. I mean, that's not, like, I take a small amount of issue with design based around really silly arbitrary limitations. Like, I also have the jump button mapped, which I will probably never actually use. And that's another thing. Like, if you have, like, a knee-high barrier, Doom Guy should be able to climb over that. But there are quite a few situations where being limited by a knee-high barrier is a thing. So I probably won't actually make use of the jump button unless I get really frustrated. I mean, in the classic Doom 1 levels, it's, I know these levels so well that... I'm not going to get frustrated, but, you know, I might play some more Doom levels later on. I might mess around with some Final Doom or maybe even some player-made mods, some custom levels. So I might get into that a little bit more, but, you know, for now it's fine. You know, I've played this game, you know, I've proven to myself that I can play the game, quote-unquote, pure, and I don't need to prove that to anybody else. So once you pick up the arrow, of course, the compass changes to show where the Keymaster is, rather than the arrow. Oh yeah, I should probably get this chainsaw. I always forget about this secret because I only recently learned how to get this. You know, all of my talk about shooting wall panels. It's surprising that I didn't remember this, but, you know, I was pontificating. Alright, so where is this wall? I think I'm in the wrong place. Yeah, and I needed to go a little further in here. So, to get the chainsaw, you have to shoot that wall and it opens, which is like one of the only, like, I'm pretty familiar with Doom 1. I'm not familiar with all the secrets, but like I can't think of any more situations where you have to shoot something to activate a switch. Like, it's almost not a thing in the original Doom. Like, that much more became a thing with Quake and Quake 2, shooting walls to activate switches and stuff, or shooting switches to open secret doors or whatever. But anyway, let's find this Keymaster. I need that key. It's selfish of the Keymaster to keep it for himself. I need that key. Alright, so it looks like the Keymaster is down very close to the exit. Which, if I can, I'll show off what happens if you try to exit a level without the key. It just gives you another message, similar to the one if you try to shoot the Keymaster without the arrow. Oh yeah, actually the Keymaster might be outside. Oh no, here he is. Alright, so I can't really get to the exit, so... So the key chases you down, unlike the arrow, once the enemy is dead, which is important if the Keymaster spawns in a place where you don't have access to, which I think... Are there any of those here? No, that might not happen until later levels. But like, if there were enemies out here that I could shoot, you know, but not physically access, it's important for the key to chase you down. Not going for 100% on every level, not going for all the secrets, just trying to make my way through the game. Which should be about 45 minutes to an hour with my additional narration and explanations and everything for the first episode. I'd say the first two episodes of Doom 1 are the ones that I'm the most familiar with, because those are the ones that were included in the 32X version of the game, which is, you know, tragically the first way that I experienced Doom. I'm a little bit more familiar with Episode 3. Episode 4 I've only played through a few times, but Episode 4 was not part of the original Doom release. That was not a thing until Ultimate Doom came out. Which is sort of a, you know, compilation of all four episodes, well, all three episodes plus a bonus episode. Because the episode that I'm playing now, Knee Deep in the Dead, was originally free, of course. This was famously one of the first, you know, major successful examples of shareware. You could play this episode for free, and then there were two additional episodes that you could buy when you register the game, and then once Ultimate Doom came out, they packaged them all together and threw an extra episode in there. So if you try to exit the level without the key, yep, need the master key to exit. So the Keymaster has it's good that it's a zombie guy, because I can kind of, you know, talk about the mechanics a little bit. The key and the Keymaster both have little, like, particle sparkle effects coming off of them. The Keymaster is red and the arrow is blue, so it can be a little bit easier to discern where they are if there's a lot going on. Yeah, because Doom is a game where there's a lot of stuff happening on the screen, and so having the little visual effect there is very handy. So this could have been a super short level if the arrow was just, you know, if it spawned near the beginning, I could just kill the Keymaster, go to the exit, I would probably be done, you know, finish it actually under the part time. But because the arrow spawned over here somewhere, I have to go hunting for it. And there are a couple other secrets that I want to pick up while I'm here. Some health, and I think this is where you first get the rocket launcher. So the idea with the soundtrack was to be more of a, you know, kind of a darker experience, sort of similar to the Doom 64 soundtrack, which was, you know, it was lauded at the time for being, you know, a departure in a good way from the original Doom music, because, you know, as much nostalgia as people have for the midis, like the fake heavy metal, you know, rip-off midis, they were never good. I mean, it's not good music. It's not something that I'll sit down and listen to for fun. And yeah, they can sound okay if you have a good sound font. But you know, they're not like stellar composition. I mean, you know, Brian Prince, the composer, he did his job. You know, he did fine. It's a little too derivative of some music, but probably not in a legally actionable way. So he performed his job. But you know, part of it is just having heard it so many times, being so familiar with it. And yeah, I know, you know, the E1M1 music is like a cultural, you know, icon. It is, you know, it's up there with the Mario, you know, Mario 1 overworld music as far as recognizability goes. But you know, I've heard it enough. Excellent. Alright, so hitting this switch will open up the big central secret area of this level. I'm not going to go to the secret levels. I'm just not a fan of them, really. But I might have to explore that part of the level to get the arrow, or kill the Keymaster once I get the arrow. So yeah, it's quite possible as I play through the levels and get to the ones that I'm less familiar with, it's quite possible that I will have a really hard time finding this stuff, because, you know, I'm not a Doom expert. I don't have knowledge of all of the secrets, and some of them can be really tricky to open. Some of them involve, you know, walking over a pressure plate and timing it just right, so that you know, walk over another pressure plate that you didn't have access to before, and just a really elaborate, you know, complicated sequence of actions. And I'm just gonna have to blow past that zombie man. Luckily, it is a zombie man. Wait. Okay, where have I not been here? Well, okay. I see. Don't know how I missed something over here, but F off, jerk. What did I miss? I got the mega health, right? Can't go in there. Is there another? No, can't go in there. Okay, so those are, wait. Yeah, there's no way to open those. Oh. Yep, see, here we go. I know I found the secret before, but oh right. There's like a whole section that I didn't go to. Okay, I'm a dummy. I have a tendency to overthink things in situations like this. Okay, I'm gonna feel really silly. Right, okay. I just never finished going this way. That's it. I do have this rocket launcher. By the way, I'm going to try to get through these levels without quick saving. I mean, the first three episodes I know I can definitely finish without quick saving. The fourth one, like I said, I'm a little less sure about. But if I quick save, the default behavior of GZ Doom is to, you know, upon death, load your most recent quick save. And there might be a way to disable that. I'm not sure. But if I don't quick save, then instead of loading a save, it'll just restart the level, which means the position of the arrow and the Keymaster will be re-randomized. So, okay, I was really expecting the arrow to be here. Alright, there must be another secret I don't know about. I was not expecting the game to get tricky this quickly. Okay, so that's where I circled around from the secret area. This doesn't open anything else, does it? I'm pretty sure it just raises this platform. And it's not going to spawn in the acid, because there are no items down there. The thing about Bull of Heaven is that all of their compositions, all of their tracks are super long. It's kind of the thing that they're best known for. And I included the full versions of the tracks in the mod. And, you know, some of the tracks are, you know, an hour long. And I never... Okay. I never, you know, tested it listening to the full tracks, because it never takes you that long to complete a level. But in this case, with this mod, I've definitely gotten this before, but it's not like ingrained in my muscle memory like some of the other levels. I just need to take a very quick handbrake, because my fingers are kind of starting to fall asleep. In order to record a game that I'm playing with the mouse and keyboard, I have to sit in a not 100% comfortable position to make room for my mic stand and everything. So, it's fine. It's just occasionally my fingers fall asleep and I just need to take a second. So, this has been a very complicated level 3, but we made it through with 200 health. Which is nice. 200 health and armor. Okay. All that, and I still didn't find all the secrets. Yeah, I was never, you know, I never cared enough to, like, figure out all of the weird stuff that you have to do to get all the secrets in this game, because there are a lot of them, and figuring that stuff out can be really tedious. Alright, level 4. But yeah, like I was saying about the music, some of the tracks I picked knowing that the player wouldn't hear the whole thing, because some of them, you know, with ambient music and with light drone, you have to be careful that it doesn't wear out its welcome. And it works much better as background music than something that you would just sit and listen to. But some of their tracks can get pretty obnoxious if you listen to the whole things. And I tried not to include the most obnoxious tracks. They have a lot. I mean, they have, like, if you go to their website, bowlofheaven.com, they have, like, 300, you know, quote-unquote albums. And they are huge trolls, and some of the albums are, like, puzzle tracks where you have to download, like, download a ping file and rename it to MP3. And there are some tracks that some people haven't figured out how to listen to. There are some tracks where it's just, you know, nested zip files that, you know, compress just a repetitive beep that if you were actually able to uncompress and listen to the entire thing, it would be, you know, trillions of years long or whatever. Like, that's the thing that they're best known for, is kind of their jokes and their trolls. But they have some actually, like, legitimately really good tracks. And I tried to highlight the best ones. Obviously, I mean, I don't want to make you listen to annoying music on purpose, but, you know, people have different tastes. Some people might be less into this kind of music than I am. And that's fine, you know. Not everything has to be for everyone, but, hopefully none of you watching take notable exception to any of the music. Well, there's our Keymaster, sort of in the opposite direction of wherever the arrow is located. Okay, I'm going to say probably in here. It's not a very well hidden secret. I mean, all you have to do is drop down into the acid, which, yeah, that's not something most people would do, but it's not that hard. I'm going to save the soul sphere just in case I take a lot of damage on this level. I can come back for it. How do I get back up there if I fall? How do I lower this elevator again? I mean, I don't see how I could have missed it if it's up there, but, like, if that's where the arrow is pointing. Yeah, once again, the compass seems to indicate that the arrow is in a place I am unfamiliar with. It's kind of funny because I say the arrow is pointing to the location, but that's, like, I guess that's technically true, but not in the way you normally think about arrows pointing at things. Although, I guess when I die, it is loading an autosave, because if it was just restarting the level, I wouldn't start with any of my weapons or anything. Huh. Yeah, I'm not 100% sure about how exactly the save system works in GZ Doom in 100% of the cases. Oh, do I need to flip that switch to access the elevator again? Is that what's going on here? No? Alright, well, let's go past the Keymaster, because even though the arrow was pointing in the opposite direction, things might circle around in a way that I'm forgetting about. Ow. Let's go in here. Oh, right, this area. Yeah, this part of the level is kind of a labyrinth, so I bet the arrow is in here. Hey, jerk. And one of the weird things about the way the Keymaster works in this mod is that getting the arrow just makes him vulnerable to damage. You know, not necessarily vulnerable only to your damage. So it's quite possible to get the arrow and then the Keymaster is just killed randomly by monster infighting rather than, you know, your actions. Which is a little strange, but I don't know if there's a way in GZ Doom to make a monster vulnerable only to the player. Like, you can make it so monsters don't end fight, which the a lot of the higher level monsters don't do that by default. But I don't know if there's a way you can make a monster invulnerable to infighting damage, so it might just be something that you have to deal with. I mean, with enough scripting, I'm sure anything's possible in this engine. You know, people have done some really incredible things with it, but that might be beyond the scope of just a simple mod. Damn it. Where the hell is this arrow? Funny, because I've completely, you know, I played through all of Doom with the Keymaster mod, and I didn't run into that many issues trying to find stuff, so it's a little frustrating that I'm already encountering this, but you know, it shows off kind of the breadth of what type of situations you can encounter in this game. Okay, there's a bunch of stuff in this labyrinth that I didn't explore yet. See, like, in a normal Doom run, I never explore all of this labyrinth. Like, I know where the key is, and, you know, that's the only thing that you really have to do here. Okay, there's another section off to the north here. Or is there? Oh, it's right here. No, nothing there. Okay, I see another path that I haven't taken. Shit! Ugh. Okay. I need to go this way. And then this way. Nope, still nothing. Alright, so the arrow is this way somewhere. Oops. Did I hit the caps lock key, Duke? That will not do you any good here. Well, it's a good thing that Soul Sphere is still there for me to go back to. Ow. Because I've gotten myself into some trouble. And of course, once you get teleporters involved, that can completely screw you up. You know, the arrow can be pointing in a direction that is impossible to get to, and you just have to teleport there. Wait a second. What is that green door I mean, it's not green. It's the color green on the map. It's another thing that I heavily customized is the auto map colors to, Oh, right, it's that switch. Okay. Well, I might as well get this. Let me just relax my hands a little bit, because this thing can be a little bit tricky to get. I want my full manual dexterity. Yeah, I'm going to have to figure out a better recording situation for keyboard and mouse games, because having my hand fall asleep every 10 minutes or so is not going to be sustainable. Okay. Alright, so you have to flip that and then quickly walk onto the platform, because there's no way to lower it again. Okay, so that's that. Unless that switch opens up something else. Okay, so all that does is lower the elevator? Okay, so it has to be on the elevator that I didn't know how to get back onto, right? Like, it has to be up there. And I don't know how to lower this elevator again, or if it's even possible to. So, I'm going to cheat my way up there. Sorry. Was not expecting this to be necessary. Is there a secret here that I don't know about? Yeah, in my trial runs with this game, I didn't have to cheat at all. What the hell is this arrow pointing at? I'm probably just gonna have to no-clip my way to the arrow. This is the beginning. Oh my god! Are you serious? The secret has been here my entire life. Oh wow. That might be the first time I've ever known about that. Well, that's the fun thing about this mod. It teaches you stuff about Doom that you didn't know before. And once again, we get the key after everything on the level is dead, so we don't get our fancy quad damage. Okay, where is the exit? This way. I wish I could replace the arrow on the auto map with a more like an arrow where it's easier to discern which direction it's pointing. That's something that I have a hard time with navigation. Because unless you're like zoomed in way farther than I am, it can sometimes be a little difficult to tell which direction it's actually pointing. Don't need to do any of this. I need to find the yellow door, which is, I mean, I guess I could just navigate with the map. Okay, well, that was a little annoying, but not too bad. I'm just getting a drink of beverage here. Almost 15 minutes for that level. Good God. I guess I should be glad that it's been difficult to find the stuff, because it makes it more interesting to watch. I mean, you know, that's what's great about, you know, randomizer mods and stuff. It makes it extremely unpredictable and therefore fun to watch, at least in my experience. I don't know if this is as fun to watch as a proper full-on randomizer would be. Which, I think there is a Doom randomizer, and I need to check that out because I had no idea how that would work. Like, one of the hardest things about procedural game design seems to be making interesting 3D spaces that are, you know, navigable. And that's not to say it's impossible. I mean, to a certain extent, that's what Daggerfall does with its dungeon design, which is one reason that game is so interesting. But you also get into some situations where the procedural generation is a real asshole, and I bet that's a hard problem to solve for, like, a Doom randomizer. Or maybe it doesn't actually randomize the levels, maybe it just randomizes, like, monster placement and item placement and stuff. I don't know. I saw on a list of randomizers, I was like, Doom? How would that work? But I haven't actually checked it out yet. But I should. I've really gotten attached to the Doom modding scene recently. Because, you know, like I said, this is one of my favorite games, Doom and Doom 2, and the fact that it is so easily extensible and changeable, you know, brings me a lot of joy. And I should probably mess around more than I have with, like, map design and stuff. That's one thing that I never really got into as far as game modding goes. Like, I'll play other people's maps, but I've never, like, I was never that interested in making my own maps for Doom or Quake or anything. Which is definitely, you know, it's a skill that, you know, you have to develop. I couldn't just sit down, you know, with a map editor and just make a great Doom map. Just off the cuff. It's something that you have to learn how to do. Okay, so this is actually the first area of the game that is, well, on ultraviolence, that is actually kind of scary, just because there are so many monsters that spawn, or so many monsters that appear. So I'm going to be a little careful here. I'm going to blow up these barrels to make sure I don't get blown up. So there's going to be a room that opens here, and I will surgically, methodically blow up all of them with my rocket launcher. And then there's going to be, I think there's another one on the other side, and it might already be open. Oh, crap. One thing that I'm not sure about as far as my controls go with Doom is what I should map the right mouse button to. Because you don't really, you know, zoom in this game. I don't really use the right mouse button, but I have it mapped to previous weapon, just for those situations where I have the rocket launcher and I need to quickly switch to another weapon. But I end up forgetting about that more often than not, so it mostly only happens when I don't mean to push it. And I don't use the mouse wheel for weapon selection because my mouse wheel is actually super sensitive, and I end up accidentally triggering it more often than I actually legitimately use it. So I have that not mapped to anything. I hate the screen color effect with the radiation suit, by the way. I wish that there was just an icon for it. Wish there might be a mod for that too. If not, it would be pretty easy to make. In my mod, Hoofin' It, I actually replaced the invincibility item with a custom invincibility item that doesn't change the screen color, because the inverse color effect is torturous to me. So I'm sure you could do a similar thing for the radiation suit. A light visor in here, I think. Yeah. Nice. Get rid of that blinking effect. Haha, you can't see me. Oh shit. Oh god. Oh, this could be bad. Was not expecting the Keymaster to be here. Oh god. Oh boy. So yeah, that's another thing. Like, if I didn't have the arrow when I came into this room, I mean, I probably could have maneuvered around it and gotten out of here. But like, if I'm in a narrow hallway without the arrow and the Keymaster is like pinning me in, I could be screwed. Like, that might be, you know, an unrecoverable situation, which is one of the interesting, exciting things about this game, or about this mod, rather. Okay, that just teleports me back out here. Okay. I don't think there is a mega health or a soul sphere on this level. I never know what to call it. The mega health, I think, is the item from Doom 2 that gives you 200 health and armor, I think. And the blue one that gives you 200 health, that's just called the soul sphere, I believe. I actually don't remember how to get into that area legitimately, so I'm just going to go back through the secret passage. Not step on the teleporter. Alright, that is the Phobos lab. Probably going to cut the video at each episode to make it a concise, self-contained thing. I never know how long I should make videos when I'm not live streaming. Like, oh, this is bad. This is potentially very bad. How do I get back out of here? Oh, well, speaking of getting pinned in the corner by the Keymaster. Okay, well, that went badly. Yeah, the door must seal you in once you go in that room. I couldn't figure out how to get out of there. Alright, so theoretically, the stuff should be re-randomized now. Although, like, I think it is technically loading an autosave. Or maybe the randomization happens, like, just after the start of the level. Because when I was quicksaving, the stuff was definitely not re-randomized. Okay, so yeah, I'm just sealed in here until I flip whatever switch will get me out of here. Which, I could have made it out of that situation if I didn't panic. You know, having an unkillable demon, an unkillable super fast demon chasing me down, caused me to not think as clearly as I otherwise might be. Okay. Well, that sucked. And that shotgun guy is going to chase me down now. But if you can get far enough away from them, they will stop, you know. They don't have, like, perfect pathing or anything. So, once you get far enough away, they'll kind of get distracted and start doing something else. Alright, I think the arrow might be in this little secret chamber here. Yeah, looks like it must be. Which, I think that just opens after I get the blue key. Nope. It opens right before you get the blue key. Oh, no. Arrow is not in here. Arrow is... Oh, right. I'm trying to blow up a barrel, jerk. Nope, not in here. Damn. These arrows have been... Ah, crap. They have been... obsequious. I think that's the word I'm looking for. Stubborn. That's not really... No, obsequious means you're like... Does it mean like subservient? So it's been the opposite of obsequious. I don't know. Oh crud, that's a lot of imps. I think I might be able to sit in a more comfortable position if I just move the microphone so that it's on the left instead of the right. Or the microphone stand, rather. It just feels so weird in that position. And I don't know why. It's like I've always had it on the right. Alright, so that door only opens once I trigger something. I think there's a switch in there. I'm getting beaten up. Oh, I don't have any ammo for that. I have quite a few rockets, but of course, shooting the rocket launcher when you're at low health is always a risk. Because no matter how careful you are, there's always a chance that an enemy you didn't see will run up ahead of you right before you shoot the rocket launcher and you blow yourself up. Especially... once I start having to deal with Lost Souls. Which I think... Do Lost Souls not show up in episode 1? That might be episode 2 and on only. Oh, hello. I totally forgot about this. That's helpful. Although, I don't know. Hold on, let me try positioning the mic stand real quick. Okay, it might be more a factor of how far away I was sitting from the keyboard than... the actual position. So I scooched myself in to the desk a little bit. So hopefully that helps. Okay, so this door should be open now, right? Yeah. Actually surprised that I have this much rocket ammo, because normally in episode 1 you find the rocket launcher and you barely get a chance to use it, but because I've been forced to get more secrets than I normally would, I actually have a pretty good little cache of rockets now, which I guess that's one reason to look for the secrets. I see an arrow. It's kind of funny because you half expect getting the arrow to be a trigger that makes a lot more monsters appear, because that's just the way Doom works. If you get an important item, this happens. Oh boy, this is a lot of demons. Actually, let me break out the chainsaw here. Double damage chainsaw. Pretty effective against demons, it turns out. I mean, the chainsaw is always effective against demons, but at double damage it is much more pleasant to use because they don't take as long to die. I never use the chainsaw that much in classic Doom just because I find the screen jittering got a test. I find the screen jittering very off-putting, so I almost never use the chainsaw, which makes things harder on me because I end up using more ammo than I probably should. But you know, the chainsaw isn't fun to use, so I don't use it. If I end up, you know, at a disadvantage, then I am more than happy to cheat my way out of it. I mean, not more than happy. I would prefer not to have to cheat my way out of situations, but I'll do it if I have to, you know. I'm not above it. I have heard of people, or heard people talk about playing classic Doom games, and they just cheat their way through 100% of the game. You know, they just turn, or not 100%, but like, huge portions of the game. Like, they'll turn on God mode and give themselves all the weapons and just, you know, tear their way through the levels. Which, you know, I mean, more power to them if they enjoy that. I don't understand what they get out of that. I mean, yeah, it can feel satisfying to be super powerful and just, you know, tear your way through hordes of enemies with no consequences and no danger. Well, I mean, you know, for a little bit, just as like a cathartic moment, you know, turn on all the cheat codes and just, you know, be an unstoppable killing machine, you know, I'm into it, but like, at a certain point, I feel like that's something that wouldn't be a long-lasting source of entertainment, you know? Like, it's not something that, you know, I couldn't play hours and hours that way because it would just get dull and tedious because, you know, with no actual danger, you are, you know, it's not really, you don't really have a goal, you know, which, you know, I know that other people play games differently than me, you know, I'm not knocking how people choose to play games or anything, it's just, it's not something I would get any satisfaction from. Alright, well, that music got a lot more intense than I'm used to hearing, because it took me 10 minutes to get through that level. Not the most complicated level so far, but definitely interesting. What is this, level 7? Yeah. So we are 7/8 of the way there, and we already found the Keymaster. Which sucks. I mean, it doesn't suck, but, you know, I would prefer not to alert the Keymaster to my presence until after I already have the arrow. Oh, well, speak of the devil. I mean, I guess from a certain perspective, what I'm doing right now isn't that different than someone just god-moding their way through the whole game. I mean, the game is not designed to be played with the potential to get quad damage, and once I have it, it kind of trivializes the rest of the level. But, you know, you have the initial danger, which is, you know, more danger than is normally present in the game, because you have the Keymaster to contend with, and the unstoppable quad damage is kind of the trade-off. You know, that's the reward for getting through a more challenging version of the actual game. Which, you know, to a purist, they might look at that and say, you know, to them, that might be as pointless as just playing through the whole game with God mode is to me. Which is, you know, that's why having such a robust mod community is such an awesome thing, because, you know, no matter how you prefer to play games, no matter what you enjoy about games, there's going to be an option for you. Or if not, then you can make one. Which I think is really cool. And if you don't feel like making one, then, you know, just wait and someone might make a version of the thing that you want to play. Like, recently, there's a Final Fantasy 1 randomizer that was released just a couple weeks ago. Or maybe less than that, maybe like a week ago, called the Final Fantasy Deep Dungeon Randomizer. And it basically takes the game and, you know, it takes away like 90% of the game, and it turns Cornelia Castle, which is the castle in the starting town, it turns that castle into like a 50 level deep dungeon. And it makes it a little roguelike-esque, which I've had a lot of fun playing around with that, because I can't stand the original Final Fantasy, and the randomizer, you know, the main Final Fantasy randomizer, doesn't make it much more appealing to me. But you know, paring the game down to kind of a basic, you know, dungeon crawler, for me, that's kind of what I want out of a game like that. And that might not appeal to everyone, but, you know, that's what's awesome about modding. You know, play the games the way you want to play them. Alright, I just need to find the exit now. I don't know why I'm, why I'm wasting time here. I mean, I don't know, you know, off the top of my head exactly where the exit is. Oh yeah, there's a soul shear around here somewhere. I should probably pick that up, because the boss level is next. Let's see. Yep, you have the armor here. Soul sphere over here. I mean, it says supercharge in the console up there, but that's not what the item is actually called. It's called the Soul Sphere. Although it might be, like, maybe it's, like, referred to as the Soul Sphere in the manual, but the actual, like, in-game asset is called Mega Health. And then the thing that gives you 200 health and armor, I think that's the Mega Sphere. And that's not a thing until Doom 2. I think. You know, as much as I like these games, I'm not like a super expert as far as the lore or, you know, esoteric knowledge or anything. I know a little bit of that stuff because of messing around with modding tools, but, you know, I definitely don't have the wiki memorized or anything. Oh, nothing there. Jumping in shadows. Hey. Man, it feels good to just melt a big group of enemies with the quad damage chainsaw. That is a very satisfying feeling. Of course, if you wanted to be super hardcore about this game, or about this mod, you can go into the options and make things really miserable for yourself. You know, you can turn off the radar icon, you can turn off start with all keys, you can turn the Keymaster health up to 10 times the normal health. Which, you know, God help you if you spawn into a level and the Keymaster happens to be like a Baron of Hell or something. Like, that would be a nightmare. Alright. That was a pretty straightforward level. Only took me 6 minutes. So, unfortunately, the Keymaster mod does not work on boss levels. And we got a little notification here. Level has no exit switches. So, that's because the trigger for finishing the level is it's not player activated. There has to be either a switch that the player manually flips or a teleporter that they walk into. And this level does end with a teleporter, but it teleports you into a room that is full of monsters, and the level actually ends when you have a certain amount of health. So because of that, the Keymaster mod doesn't work here. And it doesn't work on any of the boss levels in Doom 1, because they are all, scripted rather than something that the player activates. So, we just have a vanilla E1 M8 here, which is fine. So, first time we see Barons of Hell, which it's interesting when I think about Doom enemies, like, it's not intuitive to me that you fight Barons of Hell before you see Cacodemons. Like, to me, Cacodemons are like one of the, you know, standard, you know, basic Doom enemies. And the fact that you don't see them before you fight a boss, basically, is surprising, I guess. So yeah, once you kill the Barons of Hell, the walls lower, and you could probably make the mod work with a little bit of custom scripting, because it's not like the player will be able to get to the exit. I was trying to be cool and rocket jump my way up there, but I ended up bouncing off the wall. Don't want to try that again. But yeah, the mod is universal. It's not like specifically for Doom 1 or anything, so you could probably script away for that to work, but for now, that'll be it. I beat the big badasses. I cleaned out the moon base. Where is my fat reward and my ticket home? That's a good question. I think someone owes me a fat reward. The only way out is through. Oh, so that's where that quote originates. To continue the Doom experience, play The Shores of Hell and its amazing sequel, Inferno. So, yeah, because this is the shareware episode, you get a little ad at the end for the ones that you pay for. Alright, this has been Knee Deep in the Dead, Keymaster Edition. Thank you, John Carmack, Mike Ibarash, John Romero, Dave Taylor, Adrian Carmack, no relation to John Carmack, and all the rest. So yeah, that will do it. I will end this episode and look out for episode 2, The Shores of Hell, Ultraviolence, coming to you soon. Goodbye.